Hello and welcome to the next lecture on alkaloids. Today we will study a very simple alkaloid, conine. We will deal with the introduction and constitution of conine, degradation methods revealing the or unraveling the structure of conine, including Hofmann's exhaustive methylation, reaction with HI and von Braun degradation, and finally two synthesis of conine, Ladenburg and Bergmann synthesis. Let us see the structure of conine. It is a piperidine derivative with a propyl group. This is an propyl group at position 2. So the IUPAC name of conine is 2-propyl piperidine. Next, we come to the introduction of conine. It belongs to the class hemlock alkaloid. The botanical name of hemlock is Conium mesculatum, and this hemlock contains 5 important alkaloids: conine and methylconine, conhydrine, pseudoconhydrine and gamma conisine, out of which conine is the principal alkaloid. It is a colorless liquid with unpleasant odor and a burning taste. Its boiling point is 167 degrees centigrade and it is readily soluble in organic solvents. In chemistry, conine holds 2 historical records. First, it was the first alkaloid to be synthesized in the year 1886. And secondly, the toxic property of poison hemlock, which is known as oil of hemlock, it was known in 399 BC when Socrates was condemned to death by giving oil of hemlock. Means at that time, this oil of hemlock was an official poison given to prisoners. Conine paralyzes the central nervous system and motor nerves, which control the muscles and ultimately causes death by the cessation of breathing. Next, we come to the structure elucidation of conine, which is based on chemical analysis. The first step is the determination of molecular formula, which is done on the basis of elemental analysis and molecular weight determination, and the molecular formula is C8H17N. Next, we come to the double bond equivalence, which gives the nature of unsaturation. A, which is given by A minus B by 2 plus C by 2 plus 1, where A represents the number of carbon atoms, here C is 8, B represents the number of hydrogen atoms, which is 17, and N, C represents the number of nitrogen atoms, which is 1. Substituting the values of A, B and C, we get double bond equivalence equal to 1. Next, we come to the nature of unsaturation, which is present in conine. Conine gave no reaction on catalytic hydrogenation and bromination. With this, these two reactions give an important conclusion that conine is a saturated alkaloid and it does not contain olefinic double bond. This means that the double bond equivalence which is present, it should be in the form of a cyclic ring or a ring, cycle or a ring. Next, we come to the functional nature of nitrogen. One nitrogen is present in conine. There are two important reactions. It reacts with 2 molecules of methyl iodide to form quaternary ammonium salt. And secondly, it forms a nitroso derivative with nitrous acid. First reaction is represents, these two reactions represent that nitrogen is present as a secondary amine. That's why it uses 2 molecules. One molecule of methyl iodide converts a secondary amine into tertiary amine, and the next methyl iodide converts it into quaternary ammonium salt. So it is a secondary amine. Second important, which is a characteristic reaction of secondary amine, is the nitroso derivative formation with nitrous acid. So the conclusion is that a secondary amino group is present in conine. Next, we come to the degradation methods of conine. First is the zinc dust distillation. It gives important idea about the carbon skeleton present in conine. On zinc dust distillation, conine loses 3 molecules of water and three molecules of hydrogen and converts into conirene. The formula, as you can see, 6 hydrogen atoms are less in conirene as compared to conine. This conirene, on further oxidation with KMnO4, it converts into pyridine 2 carboxylic acid. The two important inferences are drawn from this reaction. First, let us come to conirene. First of all, conirene is a pyridine derivative. The side chain carbon atoms which are left is excluding the pyridine moiety. It comes out to be C3H7. This is the side chain which is present at carbon 2. This inference is drawn as a result of this final product, pyridine 2 carboxylic. It means side chain is present at position 2, which is being oxidized with KMnO4. So at position 2, C3H7 group is present. Secondly, as conine contains 6 hydrogen atoms more, so conine is a piperidine derivative. It is a saturated piperidine ring is present, which also justifies the double bond equivalence, which is 1, which corresponds to this piperidine ring. And conine also contains a C3H7 side chain at position 2. Finally, this is the reaction. Conine, we can represent conine by this structure, piperidine ring and a side chain C3H7 at position 2. On zinc dust distillation, it forms conirene, losing 3 molecules of hydrogen, and which on oxidation with KMnO4, this side chain is oxidized into COOH at position 2, converting it into pyridine 2 carboxylic acid. So the probable structures of conine on the basis of zinc dust distillation are 2, piperidine ring, and a side chain can be in the form of a normal propyl group. This is structure 1, probable structure, and the structure 2, it is the isopropyl group at position 2 and a piperidine ring. There are evidences in favor of structure 1, which are as follows. First is the reaction with hydrogen iodide. Conine forms an normal octane on heating with HI at 300 degrees centigrade. Considering structure 1, on treatment with HI at 300 degrees centigrade, it degrades, or the ring opening reaction takes place, converting it into normal octane, an octane. If we take structure 2, isopropyl group is present, so on treatment with HI, this structure 2 ring will open and it will convert into isooctane, but experimentally as an octane is obtained. This justifies structure 1, or evidence, this is in evidence in favor of structure 1. The product formed is in favor of structure 1. Second important degradation method is Hofmann's exhaustive degradation. Conine forms conylene, which is a diene, on reduction, which on reduction gives an octane. Let us consider this a Hofmann's exhaustive degradation, taking in view the structure of structure 1 of conine, which on treatment with methyl iodide, and secondly, first excess with methyl iodine, converting it into quaternary salt, and then treatment with moist silver oxide, it will convert into corresponding hydroxide, and on heating it converts into the ring open takes place from here, converting into unsaturated compound. Then this nitrogen is still connected with this carbon skeleton. To remove this nitrogen, we have to undergo Hofmann's degradation again, all the three reactants. Then this ring will break from here and double bond will come here. This will expel out, converting into a diene, which is a conylene. Conylene on reduction forms normal octane. If we consider structure 2, then normal octane will not be formed, it will be isooctane. So the formation of normal octane is in favor of structure 1. Final evidence in favor of structure 1 is 1-bron degradation, as a result of which 1,5-dichlorooctane is formed. Let us see how this 1,5-dichlorooctane is obtained. Considering structure 1 of conine, treatment with benzoyl chloride, it converts into an benzoyl derivative, which this reaction also reveals the presence of a secondary amino group in conine. Reaction with PCl5, addition reaction takes place at the carbonyl of benzoyl derivative, converting it into dichloro derivative. Then there is rearrangement of bonds. As you can see, this nitrogen, this Cl, it is a good leaving group, it will leave, and this lone pair of electron will come here. Formation of bond will take place. Again, there will be again a rearrangement. This bond will break, taking this nitrogen will shift its electrons here. Chloride will form bond with this carbon, resulting in the formation of this bond formation, and this nitrogen with a lone pair of arrangements. Then there will be a third electron shifting. As you can see, nitrogen will donate its lone pair here. This bond will break, Cl will expel out, it will again react with here. As nitrogen is more electronegative, it will attract its electrons from here, fulfilling its low electron demand, as a result of which this bond will break and Cl will attach here. And so finally, all these three steps leads to the formation of 1,5-dichlorooctane as a final product. Last of all, the synthesis of conine, which is the final conformation of the structure which we have dealt earlier. First is the Ledenburg synthesis. In this, the starting or the substrate is taken as N-methylpyridinium iodide. The first step, this reaction takes place in three steps. The first step, on heating N-methylpyridinium salt, it converts into 2-methyl pyridine. This is an important rearrangement resembling Hofmann's Mertius rearrangement of an alkyl iodide salts into an alkyl pyridine. Similar rearrangement takes place here also. Then it converts into this carb anion, and the second step is the carbonyl. It will react on nucleophilic. Addition reaction will take place with the acetaldehyde and the carbonyl group of acetaldehyde. This nucleophile will react at the carbonyl carbon, and then it will undergo dehydration in the presence of anhydrous zinc chloride, resulting in the formation of this propylene. This is a propenyl 2-propenyl pyridine, which now in this case, in this second step, this is the aromatic ring, and here this is olefinic double bond. So we have to reduce this also, and reduce this also pyridine ring, we have to convert it into piperidine. So the third step is the reduction with sodium ethanol. Reduction takes place on converting it into conine. So the overall reaction you can see here, and methylpyridine iodide in the at 300 degree centigrade, it converts into 2-methylpyridine, which on addition with acetaldehyde in the presence of zinc chloride, it converts into propenyl 2-propenyl pyridine, and which on further reaction with sodium and ethanol, it converts into conine. So this is Ledenburg synthesis. The second synthesis is the Bergman synthesis. Bergman Bergman took the substrate as 2-methylpyridine, which was the second step. In the Ledenburg synthesis, we have prepared this 2-methylpyridine, but here Bergman, he started his this synthesis with 2-methylpyridine as the starting compound, which on reaction with phenyl lithium, this is acetic hydrogen from 2-methylpyridine, it is converted into lithium derivative. Then which on substitution reaction with ethyl bromide, lithium bromide expels out, and this ethyl 2 carbon chain is being introduced, as this is the need here. One carbon is already present and 2 carbon from ethyl bromide, resulting in the formation of 2-propylpyridine. Next, to reduce this aromatic ring with sodium ethanol, it converts into a racemic mixture of conine. This racemic mixture is resolved by using hydrogen tartrate. In this way we get conine. So this completes the unraveling the structure of conine. It is a very simple alkaloid, and the important also from examination point of view, three reactions are very important here: the degradation methods with HI, Hoffman's exhaustive methylation, and Van Braun degradation method. And well, the synthesis, as you can see, both are very simple, Bergman and Ledenburg synthesis, very useful from examination point of view. Thank you.